It is the Elvis musical pop-up book. We go on to Elvis going into the army. And then what happens is he disappears and comes out the other side, all shaved and shorn. So you guys are in fact trying to say then that you are the sons of Elvis Presley.
Well, let me say right off the bat here, Chris, that we are not in fact impersonators. We are the illegitimate sons of Elvis Aaron Presley himself.
Yes, indeed. We're as authentic as the Smoky Mountains down there, baby.
That's right.
Because our mama told us she was an extra on Tickle Me.
That's right.
Elvis was howling one night at the full moon out by his Winnebago. She strolled over there to meet the king.
Yeah.
Had herself a dozen roses in her arms, walked into the Winnebago. Elvis gave her the best 15 minutes of her life.
Yeah, those are immortal moments to recall.
And thus produced what you're seeing right now, Melvis and Elvis Prison.
Yeah, the one and only.
And we need to thank Elvis for calling, you know? He did call. Elvis called.
I put him on hold. I forgot.
Oh, get up!
This is my dream band here. This is my dream. If I had a band, they would look and sound like this band.
I see the breeze of my soul of what's around me. This is Elvis Presley talking to you here from Vancouver, British Columbia. We only got 30 minutes to give you what we got, so this is much music.
No, and Elvis, I don't know if you know this, but while you were away, right, while you were in hiding, look, they came out with your own personal cologne for all the king's men.
That's great. That's great.
And I bet you didn't know that there were Elvis panty liners. Honestly.
No, you caught me off guard on that one.
Honestly. Well, you hunk of burning love you. Oh, this is too much.
Oh, don't be cruel now.
I have something to say.
Go ahead.
Elvis is dead, okay?
What would the world be without Ziggy? I have no idea. It would be a completely different planet, wouldn't it be? We will continue to, by the way, just to remind you, in a very short period of time, we're going to have a special edition of RSVP. You guys will be phoning us, hopefully. That'll be at 6 o'clock Eastern time for a couple hours, and it'll be tons of fun, and we'll do that again on Sunday, too. So think about the weirdest things that you can think of that you might think that we have in our video library, the most extensive music video library on the planet, by the way. We're broadcasting, doing this... Sleep is for Wimps TV marathon because we've been on the air for 10 years and it's just kind of a celebration showing you what we've been doing. And again, a day without Ziggy is a day without sunshine, and Ziggy herself, in her own words, will be able to tell you what it is that she does for a living, but it demands the appropriate introduction, if you will. This would be the height of technology, wouldn't it?
I'm working on it.
Kick it until it works.
Let me just try this one more time. No, okay, I'll give you one more shot. Here, I'm going to try it again. I'll show you how we... Okay, we're locked out. Ziggy basically says, though...
Okay, yeah, do your impression of Ziggy. Hang on, take off your headphones. Get your hair right. Okay, hang on. Okay, go.
Honest, I'll get this to work. And trust me, after the Stairway to Heaven, Ziggy will say that she does go to the library, comes here, and then goes shopping.
Okay.
After Stairway to Heaven, roll Stairway to Heaven, I'll get this thing fixed in the side.
Yep, it's as rude as it looks. That's true. I think I have to leave. This is just, can I have a second?
Go.
Okay. Very special thing before we leave. I'm going.
Welcome to Fantasy Island.
Tell me your fantasy, and I will make it all come true.
Can watermelons fly?
Yeah! It's here at Chettle's Bar and Grill, where the shuttle crews come and get liquored up before they just take off. Last beer before Saturn.
You got the shuttle guys' cars all the time. No.
Is your assistant Sylvie? And
And we have more things to come. Steve is... Where? You still on the phone? Oh, there you are. Uh-oh, he's somnambule. How do you say that in English? Sleepwalker. He's a sleepwalker. Let's follow him and see where he's going to go. Uh-oh, he's sleepwalking. Uh-oh, Sylvie, watch it. He's going to change things. Oh, there we go. Oh, we're back. I don't think he's realizing what he's doing.
His wish is to go on a date with her. She would have nothing to do with this toad. So, by the miracle of modern television, Craig, just as a kind of a final going away before you go to your resting place, here's just a little something we put together by the miracle of modern television. It's you and Natalie together. See you. This did not, in fact, happen. This is just television, ladies and gentlemen, but don't be so teary-eyed. How do you feel? Can you speak? Don't breathe on me. Don't breathe on me. Isn't this lovely? Look at this. You're just grooving. See, look at her. Look at the way she's looking at you.
Introduce yourself in your video, if you would. Camera.
Oh, I see. I'm Gord Downie. This is my friend Rob Baker. You're watching Much Music 24
in
hours
stereo.
A day.
In stereo.
I was talking.
Coast to coast.
Coast to coast.
Based on what I've been able to find out after checking all the equipment and checking your wires down here, what it looks like you're using is about 4,200 kilowatt hours per day. That's the amount of electricity you're using here per day. May not mean much to you, but to the average homeowner, that's six times what they'll use in a month. Now, if you were to look at that over the 10 years you've been in operation, what we're looking at is about 15,288,000 kilowatt hours. Let's put that another way. You like to eat? You like to eat steaks even? Well, if you had an electric grill and you had that kind of electricity, you'd be able to make yourself 45,296,160 steaks. That's how many steaks you could cook with that electricity. You like to drink coffee? Well, with that electricity, you could make yourself 364 million cups of coffee. And let's put it one more way, hair dryers. You use a hair dryer, if you had that kind of electricity, you could use that hair dryer 91,728,002 times with that kind of electricity. Any way you slice it, it's a lot of electricity you're using here.
I had a strange dream the other night and you were in it. Okay, my night was the same as always and I brushed my teeth and went to bed, but then the fun and games began. You see, I was on the set of Miami Vice. But Don Johnson and Philip Michael Thomas weren't there. In their place were you and Michael Williams as Crockett and Tubbs. Now, Mike, have you ever heard of anything as ridiculous as that? I can't believe it. The idea that you and me would be in somebody's dream. It's the most ridiculous thing I ever heard.
With
know what I mean, Mike? Okay.
So, did you get it right?
I'm telling you, man, she was a friend of mine.
I think he's got it. I saw two big ones in there, man. I don't know. We gotta get in there pretty quick.
She was gorgeous. I believe she was of Polynesian extraction.
You gotta get it right the first time, man. Yo, hey, what are you doing?
I'm sorry, man. I think I blew it.
Sorry you didn't do it, man.
Cover me, Rico.
All right. Keep it down. Keep it low. I'll be in 5 seconds.
Okay, you follow me.
Two big ones? Look out. Two big ones?